Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Adebayo Shokweju, Country Hair Quality Control, livestock247.com. Many people have been in the business of farming, going to livestock farming, and they have been wondering why they are not making so much gain and the return on investments. Some of them have been able to attribute that to mortality that they have in adults, some in the weaning stage, and some maybe the young livestock mortality. But so many people have not been able to consider the fact that there are some other time in which they have mortality right during the pregnancy. And that's what we're going to be considering today. We call it abortion. Well, abortion happens in livestock, and unfortunately many people are not even aware that abortion can occur, which is loss of pregnancy in livestock. The question is, what are the causes of abortion in livestock? Number one, I would like to categorize them into three broad categories. Number one, we have the anomalies. When we talk about anomalies, we have the management. It may be due to the fact that they are stressed, heat stress, or they are under some other stress. It may be some other reasons which we can broadly categorize under that anomalies may be the reason for the abortion. We have also infectious diseases, bacteria, viruses, fungi, parasites may also lead to abortion in livestock. And the one that many people don't even talk about, they don't know about, and even they have not been able to have a category to place them, is what we call idiopathic, in which the known source or cause is not, the reason for that is not known. And the reason why the reason for such abortions, the reason why they are not known is because we don't take a diagnosis when we have problems on our farm. We have diseases, we have infections going from one animal to another, but we don't diagnose. And because there is no diagnosis, we don't even know the reason why such a thing is happening. Number two is the reason why we don't know is because most of the researches that are conducted, the genetic part of it, very few researchers go into any form of genetic that may be associated with a reproductive problem. Another reason why we have this idiopathy, that we just know abortion occurs without necessarily attributing it to a particular cause, is because of people's attitude. Many people decide to use drugs. They don't even know their livestock are pregnant or not. They just use drugs, and the drug eventually lead to abortion. And some other time they don't keep record, so they put the livestock under stress, and eventually the livestock eventually experience abortion. All of these are the reasons why abortion occur in livestock. So the question is, how can we prevent abortion and be able to make this more return on investment? Number one is, let us ensure that we have an hygienic environment. That is essential in all farms or yards where the livestock are being reared. Number two thing that is important is vaccination. There are some diseases that require vaccination in order to prevent abortion from occurring. So vaccination is another thing that we need to consider. Another thing we need to consider is good management. Let us ensure that our livestock are under good management. Number four that we need to consider is about the estate or status of our animal. There are sometimes they will need treatment just before they go into, we mate them, that is the male being introduced to the female. And we have to ensure that, because we don't want them to eventually experience abortion during pregnancy. And lastly is the let me say relationship with the veterinary professionals. So many people think it is very costly to use a vet, but what they are losing with to abortion is actually far higher than what they could have been able to gain if they have employed the services of a veterinarian. So let's try to employ the service of a veterinarian and other veterinary professionals in order to be able to have better results in our farming, livestock farming. More will still come on your way. Thank you for listening. In case you have any question that you want the veterinary professional to answer, you can drop the question or comments, and we also want to encourage you to like, share, and follow us on all our social media platforms. Thank you.